said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, to the defense. It's the last game of the night. Danish Bears up against Scary Faces. And the draft is already underway, so we're going to jump right into it.
Oh, you love that name, don't you?
I do. I do.
Emphatically.
I turn half Bumblebee.
Be yourself, Cap.
When it comes to just be yourself.
Just be yourself.
What a great meme. Bounty Hunter, Queen of Pain for the Danish Bears, Scary Faces, Darkseer, and Winter Wyvern. You know why I emphasize the Z? Because their name, their official name, has three all-cap Zs at the end. That's why I do it. I don't know why they have it that way, but it just is. Not two, not four,
three.
Not lowercase. Three uppercase Zs.
I see.
They're a very excitable bunch.
And then they have a player called Ramses as well. Why are you smiling?
I'm just looking at a recording software, waiting to see if it's going to
die. Waiting for it to crash. Oh, God, yeah. I'm dying. Oh.
Looks like it's good.
Danish Bears have Bounty Hunter.
Yeah.
They have the overpowered little rat hero.
Yeah. I'm sure SFZ, though. They know the power of the Bounty Hunter. They lit it through. So I'm sure they have a plan. Just like they had versus the Leshrac. They're a reliable team like that. Then again, Danish Bears really showed Kuro what's up in game two. Number two.
Yeah.
After they got, I would say, trashed pretty hard in game one. So.
Well, Scary Faces, they've got themselves the Winter's Curse vacuum combo, so they know that their team fights are going to do well as long as they're off cooldown. Oh, I wish I could switch the camera back.
But you can't.
But I can't. I don't have the buttons over here. Cap's doing a little dance on his chair.
I'm having fun.
Whee!
Yeah, I'm playing around with our chair that swivels.
Swivel chairs. What happened to those stools which Toby and you had to make?
Yeah, those got
removed.
Those were not great. Those were not great. I mean, these chairs are all right.
Wooden IKEA chairs. Yeah, these have padding.
They got a backing. Well, everything's good. Everything's good. Golden in the studio.
These suit my needs. Scary Faces. I was looking at their draft actually again for them recently, and they've been playing a fair amount of Huskar. I think like 3 out of the last 10 games they've given Ramses Huskar, but banning it themselves. It's kind of interesting. I'm not sure if, like, Danish Bears obviously don't have a lot of games on record because they're a very new team.
Right.
XSplit's still going, right? XSplit's still going. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're good.
Now I've mentioned it's going to crash, though, by the way. Just letting you know. So I don't know why banning it here is a great idea. I guess the fact that they don't have too many, like, single-target lockdown spells. They don't have, you know, a Hex, a Stun, or anything like that. And maybe they're not planning on going on into any hero that does that. They've kind of got Lucent Beam and that's it, right? Arctic Burn slows people down. They've got a big Wombo combo. Mm-hmm. But they don't have anything that kind of stops Huskar in his tracks, stops him from Omelette Toggling, so they can finish him off and kill him.
Yeah, no, Huskar is just really annoying. Did you see that ESL game where Nip got a last pick Huskar?
Era Huskar, yeah.
Yeah, and that was the only game that they won. They won it in 13 minutes and 50 seconds. Huskar.
Yeah, I watched
if you don't plan for it in the draft, it's just going to destroy you. So I like the ban. Thinking ahead.
It's like the 6.84 Broodmother.
Yeah.
Kinda.
Okay. Danish Bears. They've got a Bounty Hunter. What are you going to couple it with? They don't have the Spirit Breaker, so they don't have that combination. I like it. Spirit Breaker, Bounty Hunter. Played that in a pub today. Even though I fed a lot, it's the Spirit Breaker. Didn't matter.
Track
we're
gold.
Spirit Breaker Bounty Hunter. We're getting track gold all over the place. It didn't matter.
Shadow Shaman.
Danish Bears. I think there's this Vega squadron who picked up Shadow Shaman 2 times in a row early on in the ESL qualifiers. They won one game with it and lost the other. Don't really feel real confident about this hero.
It's super good. Like controlling runes and things like that. And if you've got a Bounty Hunter with an Orb of Venom just, you know, wailing away at someone,
yeah,
you can do a decent amount of damage. Against a Darkseer, I guess you've got the two forms of Lockdown, and Aether Shock is super strong. Like, level one Aether Shock does a ton of damage and really, you know, was it 90 mana or something like that at level one? 95 mana, 8-second cooldown, you do 140 damage. So it really cannot be understated how strong that nuke is, especially against the DS who wants to be sitting on lane until he's level, you know, two or three. And if he's really under pressure, then move into the jungle. But if you stop him early enough, then he doesn't have
Storm
the
Spirit.
Greatest laning phase. And now Scary Faces have picked a Storm
Anti-Mage
into the Shadow Shaman. And Anti-Mage is the only real response there from Danish Bears.
But it's a good one. It's a hero that's going to farm a bit faster than the Luna. If you stay ahead of her, you're able to jump her with the Abyssal Blade that you pick up. And then he's a straight counter to the Storm Spirit. I like Danish Bears lineup so far. I mean, there's still the Shadow Shaman, the early roaming potential of Bounty Hunter against Storm, whether it's interrupting his stacks, harassing him in the laning phase. Then you've got the heavy amount of disables out from Shadow Shaman and the burst potential of Animage. It's always going to be hard for a Storm Spirit to play the game. So, and then Queen of Pain's pure damage can still help overwhelm.
I was just wondering, like, what is the hero here? It's not going to be Rubick. It can't be Witch Doctor, Dazzle. Nothing really fits.
I'm not sure how I feel about techies without Tusk, but unless you're AUI 2000.
Well, if you get mines down, you can A, stop Bounty Hunter freely roaming the map.
Sure.
Either you get vision or knowledge of where he is. Oh god, they picked the ogre. The one true counter to techies.
They're like, we need a hero that's just going to be able to run in and tank the mines for us.
Well, there are like three.
You know what Ogre Bajai is? He's a two-headed crash test dummy. That's what he is.
He's a minesweeper.
His life is made to be abused at this point.
There are like three heroes, I believe, that at level one survive to three techies mines.
Uh-huh.
Spirit Breaker, Nightstalker, and Ogre, I think. If I'm not mistaken.
Oh, okay.
Nightstalker's pretty tanky as well.
He's got a lot of armor.
He's got like five armor at level one.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure Ogre can survive three mines at level one. Correct me if I'm wrong, but
I'm sure he can. I would all but guarantee it.
But yeah, he is the manly, man-boobed minesweeper. So we'll see what he gets up to. But that's going to be what, their offlane Ogre? Because Noya's the four-role roaming support. Has to draw mid Queen of Pain rise on the Shadow Shaman. And Miggle.
Yeah. Offlane Ogre Maggie. Is this just an The expectation of, I thought that, like, where was the instant TP out from the techies? And where's the counter instant TP out from Danish Bears? But Shadow A, he's stopping Bounty Hunter. That's what he's doing.
Yeah. Oh, Nahas is just our lovely stats man, Nahas. Winter Wyvern and Darkseer, you know, we always talk about them as being this, you know, great wombo combo.
Mm-hmm.
Only 22 and 20 in 6.84.
But yeah.
Bounty and Co-op are 34 and 21. 62% win rate this patch.
Well, what's Bounty Hunter's win rate, though? It's got to be high.
I don't know. Like, at TI5, he went 11 and 1 for the first couple of days, right? Like, some ridiculous win rate.
Eknart. Ignite plus Orb of Venom is going to force Eknar to actually fly away. If he's not careful, he's going to be caught by Hested Joe, who could have gone for the Shadow Strike to try and slow him down and get that first blood, but holds off. The Bounty Rune. General will take the bottom lane one, unless Noya gets there in time.
And it is not stolen.
Let down. Animage will take the other one. So this is not going to be Queen of Pain in a happy place. She's going to start with a disadvantage to the Storm Spirit. A lane that you usually are able to do quite well against. So not sure how he feels about this one. Techies, what did you just do? Oh, he got the healing salve general.
But yeah, they've got... Wait, is there two landmines here? This is something they really need to do as well, is allow us to see how many mines are there. If I hover over, it kind of flashes green and goes all super crazy. So I think there's more than one.
State. He's going to be losing a large share of his mana here, but he will pick up level two. So the standard Darkseer play, take a lot of damage in exchange for getting your escape mechanism. Bottom lane, meanwhile, this is not going to be the easiest lane, even for a tanky hero like Ogre Magi. He still has a fair amount of magic damage to deal with, both the Arctic Burn as well as the Lucent Beam that'll eventually come in at level 3. Eknar, that percentage-based damage is going to be pretty good versus Ogre.
Oh, yeah. And even if he does have 7 armor.
Shadow Ace now going to play with Darkseer. So Darkseer, okay, I've seen this a number of times. This combination is really nice because you push the lane forward so much that that the Techies is able to place mines in the lane wherever he wants to. It's very tough to deal with.
And then you stop that kind of sideswipe movement from the Shadow Shaman coming in.
Whoa, they picked up first blood bottom lane. 666, Ramzes gets the kill on Noya. Thanks in part to the counter ward. Looks like a bit of a dive here in the top lane. Shadow A, he's got his suicide. Oh, whoa.
Side suicide, he's going
he's
in.
He's running in for
and
it.
And now he's dead, right?
He realizes that's not good.
Oh, my!
No! Any mage!
No way!
You did not need to challenge him for that one. Luna will kill herself to neutrals because she's a bit too low, so she'll just buy out. She's actually going... No.
That's awful for the AM,
oh,
honestly.
Oh, General's going to be caught as well. This is just disastrous on all fronts.
I don't know who's winning.
Yeah, it's got to be Danish Bears.
Everybody's losing.
Animage just died to the Techies, but they still... Let's see, they picked up the Bounty Hunter kill. Why does it feel like SFZ have gotten more kills?
Because the Techie suicide?
That's right, I was thinking about in the wrong direction. I was distracted by a sneeze as well, which never happened, so woe is me.
Oh, and Ryze, waste a sentry. No orbs there, no mines there. And this Bounty Hunter is kind of stuck on his bottom lane. Can't roam, can't courier snipe, can't do anything. Is Anti-Mage really meant to 1v2 these guys up atop? It's hard enough he's a melee carry up against the Ion Shell.
I mean, they're certainly not shutting down the Luna as much as Animage is being shut down, that's for sure. But I guess the Bounty Hunter has to stay away from the Techies at all times. Miguel is going to be the target here. They're going to try and go for him. Looks like Cold Embrace will buy Eknard some time, and they will be forcing back the Ogre Magi.
There's no more magic damage. It's all right clicks. Cold Embrace.
Yeah, Miguel's not careful. They're going to be able to burst him down, but... Noya just gets so much damage out, and they're going to turn around on him. Noya actually in some serious trouble. Another right click, and they got him in the fade time. He was...
Oh! Techies killed the Shadow Shaman.
Oh, did he run in for that mine? Oh, he did. Why did he run that deep?
I have no
idea.
It's
not like he was going to get the courier. It's 33. Oh, well. C'est la vie. Animage 10-3 compared to the Luna's 12-0. This dual lane is working out quite nicely.
Oh, hey. Noya? Oh, only 2 mines there.
Still, he's got to head back to base at the very least. And that might have just stopped General from having to go back to base. He may just try and bottle crow this one, knowing that the Techies or the Bounty Hunter isn't going to be sticking around. You go for it. The mine is ready to go. They still have a glyph, though. So, SFZ, they're going to take their first tower here. Glyph gets laid out on 9 HP. Oh, and the explosion again! Oh, man. Shadow A is good at this. He knows. He really can judge the amount of time that the landmine takes to go off and the amount of blink animation. That being said, this animage is not playing it well.
Well, again, why is Ace trying to contest that? Why does he want the deny so much?
Yeah, I don't
know. At the risk of his own life.
He probably figures like, nah, I'll be fine. I'll be able to blink ahead. Of course I will.
All things considered, this Ogre at bot lane, you know, he's farming decently for an offlaner. Noya the Bounty, along with Ryze now, turning this into an aggressive tri-lane. But Techies has been here setting up landmines. And they can't go forward.
Yeah, they have no idea what's what. middle lane. This has been a back and forth for a while. I'm waiting for General to actually jump on a Hester Joe. He has enough mana for his level 2. Are they going now? Yeah, they got the Luna. Techies can't do anything to stop that one. Damn, I was bouncing back and forth between middle and bottom, waiting for a kill to go one way or the other.
Oh, the techies, he's got mine set up for you. You're going to walk into this.
Running
into
a double kill.
Oh, the bait.
And now Ryze, is he going to be... Oh, they don't have... They've got the jump. Ryze, General, will be able to get it. The bait.
It's the moment you always dread. It's like, it's techies. It's a kill. We can kill him.
Yep.
We can move on.
We know he doesn't have suicide. He just used it.
He's probably planted his mines at like the rune spot or in the jungle or somewhere where we'll run into and be annoyed. But hiding them there in that spot.
State's got 1,200 gold, so he can actually pick up his arcane boots if he just wants to spam even more against Ace. This is not the capitalist-approved hairdo of Animage, by the way.
What's he got?
I want the white mohawk. That's what I want.
Ugh.
General? Thinking about going for him. At the same time, it almost looks like they want to try and pop General. They do have the Sonic Wave. Blink out. General, long jump forward, by the way, too long for you. Oh, no, he's going to go for it. He has the last little bit of mana to be able to claim the kill on the Queen of Pain.
Where's he going now?
Now he's just going to run right back through the lane like it's no big deal. Whatever.
TP's coming in here from the Ogre, and they've got the Shackle not in range just yet. Ryze can't get
there. Ignite slowed down. Now they have the Hex. Cold Embrace will be able to buy him some time, though, during that Shackle. The burst damage, General, not going to be able to get out. I have no idea why he thought walking straight back through that tower was a great idea, but...
He had 6 stick charges there. I think it's just that panic moment where he thought he used stick before he jumped, but... Couldn't quite get it off. I think he could have survived. I think he could have sticked and jumped himself away, but not getting the timing just right there. Now, Ace has been given a little bit of free time up at top. He's got himself a Quelling Blade. Time to hit creeps. 8 minutes in, sitting at 30 last hits, and to be fair, he's not far off this Luna. Luna is 33 for 4. She's got 2 kills and 2 deaths, while the AM obviously got shut down a ton up in this top lane. But it's free farm time for both of the carries now. A good way to come back into this game is this Bounty Hunter once he gets his track up and running, but has to Joe General, dodges a Shadow Strike, and now he's looking for a bit more.
The Hester Joe dies again. This is, it's going to be a very sad Queen of Pain. Because at that point in time, Storm Spirit just like thinks, do I start going Orchid? Like, am I far enough ahead for that? CS-wise, he's not great, though, so he would have to get a lot more kills. In fact, he's died twice, so...
It's 9 minutes in. There's been so much death and destruction. The actual CS board, it looks pretty awful.
Yeah.
No one is farming freely.
Oh, Noya! Didn't expect that one. Walked right into a counter ward. Now they... Yeah. Danish bears!
There's something wrong with the techies running this way,
They're smart bears, man. They're smart bears. They know what's up.
Are they smarter than your average bear?
Oh, they keep on running through the same area. Has to Joe. Don't do it. He knows. Shadow 8. They're still trying to bait him to the same area. He's got the suicide, though. With the mine, they're going to be able to pick up the kill. Queen of Pain.
He's nearly level 6 as well. He's actually gone for 3 points in suicide over the 3rd point in the landmines.
No, I really like that. I've seen this build a number of times. I much prefer this build. I mean, if you think about the way the techies plays when he lanes like this,
he respawn time and cooldown time.
Yeah, exactly. He runs through his mana so quickly, and you want to be able to have your suicide up as much as possible. Otherwise, you can potentially be feeding away a lot of kills. And suicide also acts as like a really good killing opportunity. So,
and his streak. He's suicided 3 times right now, so he's technically 5-0-0.
Yeah.
If you don't count the suicide deaths. Mm-hmm.
I think it's just a much more efficient way to play techies than anything else.
Oh god, Ramses?
No, they know by now. They've run through that scenario so many times. Miguel is going to go down. Doden pulled back by a general.
They think they know. But do they really know?
Just imagine like the next level bait, where like they keep running through this area, but there's no mines. Turns out the mines are like over here or something. The mind games.
Danish Bears feel pretty pressured to group up here, though. And Queen of Pain struggling to get her first item up and running. No treads, no actual progression into anything just yet. And I'm wondering, is it Aghanim's game for her? Is it Orchid time? You'd love to have an Orchid against Darkseer, Techies, yeah. Storm, Winter Wyvern.
You would. I'm just not sure if... I feel like the stat gain from Aghanim's,
yeah,
is almost a necessity for the Queen of Pain at this point. You can even say it's a bare necessity.
Amazing.
Bare necessity.
You didn't even catch on to my yogi pun, and I'm disappointed now.
What? What? Whoa.
Or maybe you just didn't hear it.
What was it?
No, I can't repeat it now. Oh. Well, General is going into an Orchid. He's got himself an Oblivion Staff already.
All right, so he feels far enough ahead. Good on him.
And that's the thing. He's sitting on almost 5,000 net worth. He's a good 1,600 ahead of that Queen of Pain. AM is catching up, though. He's skipping to victory. Ace now has his treads and a ring of health. So his Battle Fury actually isn't that bad. Timing-wise, anyway.
Next up, General. They're actually going to go for it. Sonic Wave managed to wipe him up, but now the two-man vacuum. Winter's Curse with a suicide on top. It's a golden combo for SFZ, easily able to win it. Make it a 2-for-2, but a suicide on the techies really makes it a 1-for-2.
He even had a remote mine placed, so I'm not even sure the suicide was needed. But the remote mine going to give them vision up on high ground, see Noya and Mikkel coming in from the top.
This is going to be a very late Battle Fury.
It's not that bad. All things considered.
All things considered. SFZ are up by 6, 7K. General, oh, immediately hexed up.
What's he doing?
Good lord, Ryze committed heavily for that one, even dropping the wards.
Was he invis, or was he just there by the tier 2?
I have no idea. State, he's got Surge and Mech, so he should be fine here. Fact, if anything, Noya may be dead here. Vacuum turned around, a little bit more damage. Not quite enough to Splinter Blast gets him in the end, though. Eknart running away, has Cold Embrace right before the last tick there. Has to Joe. He's going to be forced back. The pings go out. Mines, they know. But what they don't realize is only one mine. Shadow A. Like, you only have to, like, that's the thing, right? They have to afford so many counter wards to play safely into cliff areas. Techies has shown himself for like the last 2 or 3 minutes, but they're still like, no. There could be like 5 mines on top of that cliff. Your imagination just starts running wild against the Techies.
Techies is doing the split pushing game now. Planting mines to basically to the south of him where this entrance comes into the lane so he can push the lane with landmines, keep the remotes here. No one can actually jump on him and stop him from doing this. The fight actually going to kick off a bot lane with the curse.
Ace, he's done for. Winter's Curse leading the way. Now Doan's going to get picked off as well. And they might as well just run away with that Bounty Hunter. He's not going to be able to help out one bit.
He bought his Claymore. Anti-Mage. Baby steps towards the Battle Fury. And yeah, Hester Joe with his point booster going into the Aghanim Scepter. But techies. 5 remote mines up at this top spot.
And he was placing them while he was hitting creeps, though. Yeah, I can't imagine. Danish Bears don't know.
The little square is drawn. They just said, this area, not safe. Do not enter this area. It's going to be a case of farming the jungle, pretty much.
But this also means cutting out so much farm away from... Like, you just, like, leave the mines there. Well, they're never going to push forward, right?
Yeah, what are you going to do? They need to start racking up some track kills here. The Bounty Hunter, he's level 7, and They've got Serpent Wards. They can actually push into this tier 1 mid. Now they know that Tekkies has been top for quite some time. He's been sitting there mining, pushing. So there aren't really going to be big stacks of mines towards the middle lane. They can, you know, pretty nicely move towards it. Maybe place the Serpent Wards down and take a team fight. Maybe even pick off this Winter Wyvern.
Yeah, he's very dead. Turned into a chicken. State. Oh, they actually lashed him there.
What?
Can they actually still get him? Turn around wall, zoning wall. Got him.
See ya.
It works. Danish bears immediately run away.
How do you touch the techies?
I don't think you do.
Anti-mage is farming the offlane. No one's stopping him. Like, the Luna's farming jungle, Helm of the Dominator. And this is something we've seen a fair amount of Scary Faces with their Luna picks, is that they kind of bide their time. Maybe they battle it relatively early on, they find these little skirmishes, but a lot of the time they don't want to take big team fights until this Luna is ready to go. So it's going to be Drums, Aquila, Helm of the Dominator, Treads, and
they
then
can get so
fight.
Much suicide! I was just thinking if they get a bounty kill on this Tekkies with the dominating streak, they'll get so much. But he gets off the suicide in time.
Oh, you still get the gold. From track, anyway.
Do you?
Yeah, I was wondering that. In the fight recap, the bounty got 200 and the quap got 50.
Huh. That's cool.
So I guess the suicide, well, obviously the track works when people die, I guess.
So it happens with neutral kills, too? Hmm. Interesting.
Hmm.
Small stack here. You see the fresh ward being placed in order to block out the stack, but Ramzeez, he's already happy with what he's going to get. Bounty Hunter's going to try and leech some of this.
I was told you cannot leech ancient experience.
Oh, you can't. You're right.
So he's standing there for nothing, and they've
been dusted.
There
was a, I didn't know there was a rule for neutral specific, or ancient specifically. I just figured neutrals are neutrals.
There are no rules in this game. It's all exceptions. Dota 2,
he's
boys.
Just sitting there. He's like 565, 565, 565.
I'm not gaining anything. Maybe he can get the courier.
No.
Oh, no, micro. They know. They see him. They've seen him. Speed burst. Run away. Run away. You're not going to courier heaven just yet.
Danish bears, though, are going to be able to take a tower finally. I'm dropping wards, I guess. Yeah, they know they need to get out. Orchid placed on Rise. General has used every little bit of mana he has to be able to get this kill. Now a nice Winter's Curse. He has a Remnant over the top. Heads to Joe barely gets away from that one in time, but Doden isn't going to be as lucky. Oh, Sonic Wave at the tail end of that one will take out the Winter Wyvern, but it's still 1-2.
And the Vac barely missed that quap as well. They could have had the two people Vac back into death. But Hester Joe, you've got to count your lucky stars that you escaped that one, my friend. Aghanim Scepter isn't far away from him, but things are not looking great.
Yo!
Especially when, did you catch that?
Not quite.
I was just looking. I didn't even see the mines there. I was just watching Anti-Mage. You know, he's farming, he's getting his gold, and then all of a sudden, detonation.
Deggies!
Fresh blood!
I didn't see any blood.
Man, what a hero. Level 2 remote mines, ready to go. And I feel like he should have more fun than this. Does he really only have... That'll help. That'll help. They knew about it, too!
Oh, boy.
They knew about it! They saw it happening in multiple occasions while he was CSing, while the Queen of Pain was invis. He had his arcanes, too. Look at him. He had his arcanes.
Who had what?
Queen of Pain.
Aghanim's.
Oh, sorry, Aghanim's.
I'm sitting here thinking, who are Tekkies has done a number on your mind.
Tekkies game, man. Wait. The Hush just said you do get gold from track. And duel wins even when Tekkies suicide.
How does Tekkies suicide during a duel?
Check yourself before you wreck yourself, my friend.
What?
Jump in, Rise. Hello. Why are the mines on the side here, do you think?
Reasons. Yeah, I'm wondering if it's because he can... No, you can't get in here to place them.
He's been sitting here.
I don't know. Maybe he wants to make like a great wall of mines where he just places, you know, a big block of them all across here.
Yeah, I guess so.
No, he's placing the wall in one big chunk.
I don't know. Well, then they know. They have track on him. They know where those mines are.
But do they care? Because here's the timing push. Here's the Luna. Oh my god, my mind. Here's the Luna with nearly a completed BKB, and they're just taking this tier 2.
She's got casual double damage. Plus 30. Plus 30%. She's hitting for 200 damage a hit already.
Little Alpha Wolfie.
Oh, Ace. He's been caught by the Orchid Storm Spirit. A TP away will not save you.
He's got Battle Fury, though. 21 minutes in. His farm can begin.
All things considered. BKB for our Luna after the Helmet Dominator. Blink Dagger now for the Darkseer. Items just rolling in for this team.
Techies nearly has his Aghanim Scepter as well. Noya, this could be a big kill. There's Suicide available, but they don't have any jump. This is one of the big things here from Danish Bears. They've got Queen of Pain to blink forward, but every single pick-off or fight that they need to take relies on the Shadow Shaman being in position, the Bounty Hunter scouting people out, the Ogre walking in, lumbering into a team fight, and then Quap blinking in to help.
Yeah.
They've got this like four-man fighting squad, Anti-Mage off doing his own thing. But everything's so positional-based, whereas the past two games, Scary Faces, they've had mobile heroes. They've got Surge, they've got Ball Lightning this game, Arctic Burn, hell. Even that's a mobility ability from the Winter Wyvern. They can reposition themselves. They can get out of harm's way. And then you factor in the techies' minds. The ultimate way to cause havoc and stop mobility, stop people getting into position to start team fights, are landmines and remote mines.
Did they actually miss the remote mines? Or are they just know this stack is here and they're looking for a separate stack? It's got to be it, right?
No comment.
Earlier, I did see the Ogreman Child like run in this area, and the ticket I was just waiting for. I was like, "Oh my goodness,
it's gonna happen! It's gonna happen!"
Bloodstone being built by Z General. Everyone should have Z's in their name for Scary Faces. He should have Z General. Instead of a 2, he should have a Z. You should call him Shadow.
Shadoway. Zdate 21. I mean, Ramses does have.
Yeah, he's got plenty of Z's. He's probably the one who made the name.
He's got one.
but he was probably the one who made the name. He's probably just like, I really like Z's. Let's drop some more. Noya, they've got a Splinter Blast Vacuum, everything they need to get the kill.
You know, this techies actually hits pretty hard. With Luna Blessing, with Luna Blessing and Alpha Wolf damage, he hits pretty freaking hard.
He's got regular damage and he's got 700 range. Must be OP. Watch him get this last hit.
Oh! He got it.
Techies. 25 to 13. Game's looking rough for the Danish Bears. 12,000 gold lead for SFZ, 12,000 experience. Desperately trying to split push, but you can't just leave a techies alone against your base, especially when the Luna right beside him.
Timing push from Scary Faces. Arachs have fallen. The Quap has no life.
Yeah, once the tower's down, you're so done for. Like, because Luna's incredibly good at clearing through both sets of racks, because, like, the Tier 3, you can't bounce anything, but the moment the Tier 3 is down and you start hitting the racks, the glaives start bouncing to everything, and it's so hard to defend into that. And then you also have the Techie's Mines, which he places between the two racks, and it hits both buildings. Like, if you're ever going to defend, you have to all-in defend your Tier 3. You know, like, in some lineups, you just, like, give up the Tier 3, and you're like, okay, we're going to wait for them to come a little bit farther into our base, you know?
Okay, Ryze has had enough. He has purchased the one item that can counter the Techies hero.
Yeah, well, you've already lost on Lane Rags. I think this might be too late. Like, I think you made your final stand a bit too late.
Yeah, when the Storm is sitting at 13,000 net worth. And Doxer with Greaves Blink. They've got the combo. They've got the Winter's Curse Vacuum. Techies, hello?
They don't know, man. They really don't.
Uh-oh. Spaghetti-o. Didn't get the Quap, though. Only got the Ogre. But that's annoying.
Wait, what?
General, he's found Ace here. Sans up.
Pull back. We'll be able to get that kill without the Manta. He is bounty. So susceptible to that. Now Noria's going to be spotted out by the Dust as well.
And Ryze is there with a double bracer gem smoked up. I don't know what he was... I think he was going on like a dewarding mission or he's going to... Because there's no tower there, right? He's not going to go and Serpent Ward the tower or anything like that. But he's lucky he didn't get caught as well.
Gem for the Winter Wyvern with the cloak. And we're just going to watch Scary Faces get an Aegis and then push uphill again.
How do they even stop? How do they kill the Luna even? I don't think they've got enough damage. They have to try and Hex Shackle the Storm Spirit without getting vacuum walled into Winter's Curse. Again, it keeps coming back to positioning. They can't physically position themselves into a teamfight engagement where they are the ones looking to make the first move such that they don't get caught by the combo from Scary Faces. Like, they have to find a pick now at the tier 2. Or something like that, or stop them pushing before they get to the base. Or they just let the racks fall and try and get a little bit of gain elsewhere. Like, Anti-Mage farming the jungle should be split pushing a little bit up on top. Try and take the tier 1 at least.
Because he's not even going to get that much before their tier 3 falls.
He's not fit to fight.
No. Look at him. Techies just doesn't care. He's going to throw out the Aghanims. They know the mines are there. I think I keep saying that, but... And Techie's minefield sign should be a giveaway. Ryze runs in, managed to get up the Hex off on General, but Ramsey just runs forward with his ultimate, dishing out so much damage. They're going to get a Noya on the side. Sonic Wave gets laid out. Still not enough to finish off Ekinar. In fact, Hester Joe's now going to be orking it up as General goes from hero to hero. God. Diving into the fountain, he's just not stopping. Manta picked up by Ramsey's inside of that one. Animage comes back and immediately gets blown up. Winter's Curse, wall. Hester Joe blinks right over it. And now, multicast.
Did you hear that Mana Void get canceled out, though?
Yeah.
The Glimmer Cape on General, then dodging away from it. Maybe Ace could have found a big juicy kill there. Shadow it. Is he still on the same streak?
Yes.
He hasn't died normally once. He's always suicided.
And once upon a time, he was 5-5-3, and he still only has 5 deaths. So, yeah. He hasn't died a single time. Desolator on the Storms here, just to make things a little bit better. You ever seen a Techies throw the minefield sign, like, on the fountain?
No.
Yeah, you could just go ahead and throw it into the fountain area.
That sounds awful.
Yeah.
Not all
like
for
what
the
are you going to do? You just like, you can't leave your fountain?
I know they're there. You're going to TP out, right? You have to TP to your ancient or something.
Here's the play. You have to smoke and then wait and then run out.
So he blows them up prematurely.
Yeah, you just got to just hope he doesn't blow it up at the right time in order to escape your fountain.
Luna and Storm are dead. Storm not dead for long, though. Anti-Mage now jumping, looking for Ekinar. Gets the Mana Void down, but...
Oh my god, he still can't kill him. He's not going to be able to get him. Guardian Greaves heals him back up. SFZ. The Storm Spirit's coming. He's going to make a long jump soon. I know he is.
3, 2, 1. General, go!
Do it.
Go! With your Desolator, with your Yasha. Come on!
Going on Anoya, Cold Embrace stopping him from being able to get these kills. Winter's Curse actually on 4 with the wall over the top just before the throne explodes. And the game ends.
2-0.
SFZ are going to join new team in a 2-0 in their bracket. The CIS team's performing well. Danish Bears will drop down to a 1-3 right now. It's kind of looking like the favorites here of this group is... For me, new team, Scary Faces, and Kuroki's team.
Yeah. Looking pretty hot.
CIS team taking over. They just won. Vega Squadrons just took ESL 1, New York European qualifier.
Well, it looks like in that qualifier as well, there were three CIS teams plus NIP, right? CIS teams, it's the rise.
Yeah. CIS looking strong. All right, guys, that it brings our evening to a close. So I hope you guys enjoyed all of the defense action, as well as our beautiful studio.
It's so pretty.
Yeah, it looks great. Anyway, we are going to close down for the night. Thank you very much for tuning in. We'll be back tomorrow at 20 CEST. I'll be casting with Blitz, Durka. You're going to be on joinDOTA Blue or ESL?
ESL.
ESL, joinDOTA Red. Going to be doing some Go for Dota.
Mm-hmm.
That's where you can find us tomorrow. Time being. We'll see you guys next time on the live stream.